Okay, brothers and sisters, I have returned, and this is my second video, just back to back here, and hopefully, by the grace of God, I can give words for people. The pattern that the Lord has dropped on me this week, these two videos I made, as I mentioned yesterday, and then the one I just made, was the Lord just dropped a message on me after I started recording, and he's just taking me from glory to glory, line upon line, precept to precept, to greater faith, and I praise the Lord for it. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, creator of heaven and earth, hallelujah, God most high, restorer of all things, renewer, reviver, rejoicing, hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you the praise. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. And the Lord is just telling me that he renews all things. You know, when we die, I mentioned this before in another video, we have this same body, but it's renewed. It becomes a glorified body. It's the same body, but renewed. When God heals you, people make a statement. I hear all these people saying, oh, God gave me a new heart. But really, he renewed the heart you had. When you get saved, yes, you become a new creature, but you're renewed. He renews you. He's going to renew the earth. That's why even in the Bible, the Greek word there, when he talks about there's a new heaven and a new earth, people think the whole earth will be destroyed, but that's not what it's saying. It'll be renewed, remodeled, remade, because the Bible says two or three times, it is a world without end. Amen. The world will not be destroyed, but renewed. We, our earthen vessels, will be renewed with the resurrection, a.k.a. the rapture, for us who are truly saved. We'll get our new, renewed, glorified body. Praise God Almighty. Blessed be his holy name. Hallelujah. I'm playing a little music in the background too to inspire me as the Lord leads me. I don't think, I don't know if you can hear it. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. As the Lord just keeps putting that into my spirit. Because in the song it says, I praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Let the earth hear his voice. When you know when someone's preaching, it's God speaking, proclaiming through his servants to people. His word. Let the earth hear his voice. And then it says, great things he has done. Give him the glory. Great things he's done. So when someone gets saved, as I mentioned in the video when I did the funeral of my father-in-law, that's a message that the Lord gave me. And the Lord has put it back in my heart to speak it again to you. In case you didn't see that other video that I did. Someone gets saved, we give God the glory. No preacher did it. The person that got saved didn't do it. God did it. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. I want to try to work on this list. And I don't know how many names I got here. I'll try to finish this sheet. Okay. Cynthia M. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. I ask you guys to pray with me. We're outside space and time here. When your prayers will be added to mine, even though it's going to be in the future. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Cynthia M. Hallelujah. You guys come in agreement with me right now. Let's pray for all these people as I name them. Pray with me. Pray with me in Jesus' name. Lord, we praise you, Lord, for the answer, Lord. For the answer cometh on the wings of a dove. Sister Cynthia M., the answer. Behold, the answer cometh on the wings of a dove. Now, I don't always know what it means, what the Lord is telling me. The wings of a dove is it comes by a piece. It could be that, you know, like mail, your mail, like air mail, whatever, like a letter. Or the peace, you know, dove represents peace. The Holy Spirit, the answer comes on the wings of a dove. Hallelujah. Maybe you're seeking to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, be filled with the Spirit. Now, it's going to come by the Spirit of God. The Lord has given me interpretation. So I'll correct myself. The Lord has given me interpretation right now on the fly. Of course, it'll come by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit brings the answer to you in Jesus' name right now. I speak it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Stanley, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Stanley, Lord, we pray for Brother Stanley right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I keep hearing, I know your name is Stan Lee, and then I hear stand up. So stand up for what's right, stand up against the enemy, stand up for what's right, stand and do what the Lord wants you to. I hesitated because your name is Stanley and I was making sure that's what the Lord is telling me. Stand up. Stand for what's right. Stand. Having done all, stand, the Bible tells us. Ephesians chapter 6. Such to put on the armor of God. Having done all, stand by faith. Eddie, friend of Rosemary. Eddie. It's another person that's in prison. I ask you guys to pray for Eddie, who is in prison. That the truth would come out, that his innocence would be made known, or his guilt would be made known, that it would be clarified what's right in Eddie's situation, that justice would be done for Eddie. Let's pray for him right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, Lord God, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory, hallelujah. Lord Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah. And the Lord is just telling me that you've been saying, is there mercy for me? Is there mercy for me? That you've been asking God. And the Lord says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man opens to me, I will enter in, and he will sup with me, and I will sup with him. The Lord stands at the door and knocks. Let the Lord enter in. Let the King of Glory enter in, Eddie. Eddie, let the King of Glory enter. He stands at the door and knocks. Answer the door to the Lord. Invite him in. Surrender all to the Lord Jesus Christ. Eddie, surrender all to the Lord Jesus Christ. Eddie, surrender all to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Jane, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Jane. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. We give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And I hear the name Jim, or, you know, the like a jewel, a gem, or the name Jim in relation to you, Jane. And that's what I keep hearing, Jim. So it can be a man's name, J-I-M, or a gemstone is what I thought of when I first heard it. So, I mean, you know, like rewards in heaven, maybe. But Jim is the only word I get for you, Sister Jane, so far. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, you know, people ask me to clarify. You know, later on, if I pray about it again, maybe it'll come back. But let me give words to other people. So maybe that means something to you, Sister Jane. It's Jim, either the name of a man, Jim, or a gemstone. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, light of the world. Sister Jane, I hear the expression light of the world. Hallelujah, that's the Lord. It's the light of the world, and we are to be salt and light in the world. Hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Sandy, hallelujah, Father, we give you all the praise, all the glory right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. And by faith, we just listen for you and wait on you, Lord, to speak. Not by might nor by power, but by thy spirit, Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. I just pray for Sandy right now. I see a rider on a horse. And the rider on the horse is a bride. Wearing the veil of a bride. Sandy, the veil of a bride. Riding on a horse. So I believe, you know, maybe you want to get married, or your daughter's getting married, or you're getting married, something like that. A wedding. Of course, it could be the marriage supper of the Lamb, right? Maybe you've been praying if you're going to be part of the bride. I don't know. Sometimes, you know, things are spiritual. Sometimes they're literal. It's a bride riding on a horse for you, Sandy, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Rebecca. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Father, we just pray for Rebecca right now. For Rebecca, hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord is saying, lift up your voice, lift up your head, lift up the feeble knees. Hallelujah, that's, I believe, Hebrews about chapter 12. Hallelujah, lift up the feeble knees, lift up your head, lift up your voice. For the Lord is highly exalted and worthy of praise. Hallelujah. It's time. It's time. It's time. Becca, Rebecca, it's time. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It's time. It's time, Rebecca. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Tracy, hallelujah. Tracy, hallelujah. Father, we pray for Tracy in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Tracy, right now I hear quarter. I hear quarter, something. Quarter. Now there is a quarter of something, one-fourth of something, a quarter. There's a quarter of a dollar. There is a, somebody's room is quarters, but it's quarter that I hear. Quarter. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus. For Tracy, that's the one word I hear, quarter. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe it's one-fourth of something that you're going to receive. I don't know. Like an inheritance or something that you want to know about what to give or what to receive, a quarter, 25%. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, we pray for Sammy. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. I just see that. For Sammy, I just see, you know, you ever seen a plantation and it's got all these live oak trees that come down like a tunnel going to the plantation house? Well, the Lord just gave me interpretation. It's a mansion. I see a mansion, Sammy. I see a mansion for you. Of course, Jesus said in John chapter 14, in my Father's houses are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. You know, the Lord goes to prepare a place for us. So, Sammy, you've got a mansion in heaven. That's what I'm seeing. This beautiful, like one of them, you know, old-timey plantations with all the live oaks going up to it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe you're from Georgia. I don't know. I don't know that. But I see that mansion for you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. Creator of heaven and earth. What a blessing. Catherine, hallelujah. Pray for Sister Catherine in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I hear for you, Catherine. And the Lord keeps giving me this. The Lord does patterns, you know. And so he keeps giving me like one word for lots of people. For Catherine, I hear the word start, you know. Go start, start, start. So probably you've been asking, Lord, you know, when am I going to do this and do that, like make videos or go do this and for the ministry or whatever. The word from the Lord is start. Start, that's it. Paloma. Paloma. Let's pray for, I guess that's a female name. I know you've messaged with me a few times. But, you know, lots of times people don't say whether they're a woman or not. But I do believe that name Paloma with an A would be female. Far as I know. So, sister, I'm sorry if I'm wrong. Right now, we just pray for Paloma. Sister Paloma in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. The Lord is telling me for you to exhort. To exhort. Maybe you've been rebuking someone, and the Lord wants you to exhort that person. To exhort. You've been doing more rebuking, I guess. It's time to exhort, to lift up, to tell, you know, to give people the positive good news. There's a time to rebuke, but you need to exhort. Exhort in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Paloma, you need to exhort. Obviously, like I said, I believe maybe you've been rebuking someone and you need to exhort them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thomas. I hope you're not a doubter, like Doubting Thomas. Father, we pray for Thomas right now in Jesus' name, Brother Thomas. Hallelujah. The giftings and callings of God are without repentance. Thomas, the giftings and callings of God are without repentance. Hallelujah. What is that? Is that Romans chapter 9 or 11? It's either Romans 9 or 11. It's in there. The giftings and callings of God are without repentance. Hallelujah. Kate, right now we pray for Kate in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we just pray for Kate right now. The Lord is saying, Kate, lift up your voice. Let your voice be heard. Kate, let your voice be heard. Lift up your voice and let your voice be heard. Hallelujah. Gracie. Good night, Gracie. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Gracie. Father, I just speak, yes, Lord, your blessings right now. Hallelujah upon Gracie. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, I see a baby. I see a baby, Gracie. I see a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. And, you know, like in all wrapped up. A newborn baby. Hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name. Somebody gave me the name White Dove. People, please give you a real name. There's a White Dove. Hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name. We pray for White Dove. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord is telling me to say, speak, and he will answer you. You know, ask, and you shall receive. Speak, and the Lord will answer you. In Jesus' name. White Dove, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. John F. John F. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. I hear the word deliverance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear the word deliverance. John F. Deliverance. 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 Hallelujah. I see, also see a tractor, you know, like for planting and harvesting, farming, but I'm sure it's a reference. You know, sometimes references are literal. You're literally a farmer. But 99%, it's talking about planting and harvesting. You're talking about sowing and reaping the word of God and like, you know, a laborer in the work of the Lord. But deliverance. So let me put that together as the Lord is just giving me the translation. The Lord wants you to do it. It's just, in a way, it's simple. When the Lord tells me, I say, why didn't I think of that? And I was like, duh. Deliverance ministry. Deliverance ministry. The Lord wants to use you in a deliverance ministry. John F. Deliverance ministry. How I miss those things, you know, when the light turns on, when the Lord turns on the light, it's, you always think, how come I couldn't see that before? Because the Lord didn't let us see it. Hallelujah. Just like the disciples. Jesus kept telling the disciples that he would be crucified and the third day he would rise again, and they didn't get it. They were afraid. They were like, well, he's dead. What are we going to do now? You know, that's why when he appeared to the disciples on the road to Emmaus, he said, you know, you're slow of believing, and, you know, you're hard-hearted and slow of believing and all that. Just, you know, that's how we are, right? We're only humans. As the Bible says, call God to remembrance that our frame is weak and we are but dust. The Bible tells us, I believe it's in Isaiah, where God says, you know, remind me, call me to remembrance, you know, and that, you know, and tell me that your frame is weak and that you're made of dust. And, you know, that he would have mercy on us in our humanness, humanity. Let's see. Lola. Father, right now in the Philippines, Lola means grandma. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Lola right now. Father, hallelujah, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We just pray for Lola right now. Well, I just see a glory, the light of glory on worship. I see people doing worship, praise and worship with light of glory on them. That's what I see for in reference to you, Lola. Hallelujah. Rebecca C. I already did a Rebecca. This is Rebecca C. Hallelujah, Father. I don't know if that's the same, you know, and maybe the same Rebecca asked me twice, but this is Rebecca C. There's another Rebecca. Hallelujah, Father. We give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Rebecca C. Father, we thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Blasphemy of the Holy Spirit is the unforgivable sin, the only unforgivable sin. If you have blasphemed the Holy Spirit, you would not be worried about it. You would not be thinking about it. You would not be asking about it. Or maybe you're worried about something else being unforgivable sin, but the Lord told me, this is what I said. Blasphemy of the Holy Spirit is the only unforgivable sin. And if you committed it, you would be reprobate and you wouldn't care anything about the Lord. You wouldn't be concerned about the Lord. If you had committed the unforgivable sin, you would be like an atheist. You would have no desire to know anything about the Lord, anything about God. No repentance, no remorse. You would have a reprobate mind. So that's what the Lord wanted me to tell you, Rebecca C. Tracy S. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tracy S. The Lord is just speaking to me about sin, the word sin. Sin. Hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You know, I very rarely or don't like to say any, you know, I mean, that's what the Lord is telling me, the word sin. And people will message me and ask me, I don't know. Unless the Lord would tell me. But the word I hear from the Lord is sin. Sin. In Jesus' name. Father, let's continue. I ask all you guys to continue to pray. Anytime I ever give somebody a word that sounds so great, I ask you to continue to pray for them for clarity and understanding in their heart. They will understand what the Lord is trying to say. Right now, we just pray continually, Lord, for Sister Tracy S. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And the Lord is speaking to me about deviation. 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 To deviate means to go off the path. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. So Tracy, if it's talking about you and that's what you're trying to find out, you heard. All you got to do is repent. 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Sister Tracy S. Melissa. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. I thought I heard the word either wart or worry. Sometimes the Lord will only tell me once. Hallelujah. Let's pray for Sister Melissa. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hear the word wart again. Father, we give you the praise and glory, Lord. We just pray for healing of Melissa, deliverance. Maybe you're a worry wart. Well, worry wart goes together now, doesn't it? Maybe you are a worry wart. That's what the Lord is trying to say, because I thought I heard worry and I thought I heard wart. Duh. I just realized that a worry wart is a common expression. Sister Melissa, maybe that's what it is. You're a worry wart. We're going to pray. I'm asking everyone to pray for Sister Melissa, because to worry is to sin. You know, it's to fear, and fear is to sin. Because doubt and unbelief is to sin. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. Now, when we're worried, it's normal to have worry to a certain point. You got to give it to God, is what I'm trying to say. It's a sin, you know, to be worried and not be in faith. Give it to God. Give it to God. Ask the Lord to forgive you of your fears and doubts. Give it to him. Go look that up. 2 Timothy 1:7. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. Now you keep repeating that self to yourself. Faith comes by hearing of the word of God. So you're hearing the word of God out of your own mouth, and you're hearing it, and you'll increase in your faith. And the Bible says, you know, that God has not given us a spirit of fear. As I just told you, God has not given us a spirit of fear. There was another Bible verse I want to quote. I've got so many of them coming on me at one time. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. Get that down into your spirit. You know, feed on the word. Keep declaring the word unto yourself. That you will be... Now I remember what I was going to say. The Bible says, you know, to bring every thought, every vain imagination. You know, the word image and imagination is the same word. You know, you have an image in your mind of all these bad things happening. You know, that's an idol, an image. You know, like an image of the beast. You know, worshiping an idol, image. It's the same thing, imagination. You know, it's an idol, an image. You know, the Bible says to bring every thought and every, you know, vain imagination into captivity to the word of God. So in other words, I am full of fear that something bad's going to happen to me tomorrow, as an example. Okay, but God says he has not given us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power and of love and a sound mind. So I need to bring my thoughts into captivity to that God has not given us a spirit of fear, that I shouldn't have fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. Renew your mind with the word of God. You see what I'm saying? When you fill in your mind with things that contradict the word of God, you're saying, hey, God, you're a liar. Hey, God, I don't believe what you say. I believe what I want to believe, and I reject what you want me to believe. You're in doubt and unbelief. And the Bible says that without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Hebrews 11:7. Hebrews 11:1. Read all of 11. Hebrews chapter 11. Verse 1 of Hebrews 11. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now faith, right now. Go look at some different translations if you can't understand that King James words. Sister Melissa, God bless you. people's going to be praying for you. Tracy, people's going to be praying for you. Brother Eddie, people's going to be praying for you. Wendy W. So Wendy W. We're going to pray for you right now, Wendy W. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. I hear the word clandestine. Clandestine. Hallelujah. A clandestine is some kind of a, you know, a false flag, undercover, like someone is using a different name that's not their name. Someone is opposing as something that they're not. Clandestine. Clandestine. That's the word that Lord gave me for you, Wendy. Maybe it's someone else is an imposter, or, you know, I'm giving some negative stuff here. I don't know if it's you or someone else, you know. You know, like being a hypocrite. It's to be a clandestine Christian. You know, to go to church doesn't make you a Christian, as Billy Sunday said. Maybe it's someone in your family. Maybe it's your husband. I don't know. But it's clandestine. And like Billy Sunday said, you know, going to church makes you a Christian about as much as sitting in a garage makes you a car. You know, so clandestine. We're going to pray right now for Wendy. Hallelujah. Wendy W. In Jesus' name. Father, just pour out your spirit. Pour out your wisdom. Pour out your glory, Father. We honor you. We praise you, Father. I just pray for all the people on this list in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lord, have mercy. God, have mercy. Deliver your people from evil, Father, in Jesus' name. Deliver thy people from evil, Father. I ask in Jesus' name. Father, we praise you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Some of these people, I got their names twice. I got one more list. I'll try to do it tomorrow. This is already long. As the Lord leads me, God bless you guys. Still working on it. Still got about 25 names. I'll do it in another video.